มิงลาวะอังเกอเนี่ยไม่บลูคอลเลจอ่ะกูเบ้อันนี่ลาไปแล้วมาดีไปเยลงงานเราทําได้ใช่จนเราไม่รู้กันลาวะกันนะอ๋อที่ลงงานอ่ะกูเบ้เชียร์อันนี้ซะไปลงแค่อ่าที่อยู่ที่กองเนี่ยไปเยเนี่ยบ่เนาะบลูชายอ่ะแหละบ่บลูชายอ่ะเลยสรแล้วเราไอ้ตะไนมาตู้อ่ะเราไปลีอ่ะงาที่เราตู้อ่ะบ่เนี่ยจนเราตู้อ่ะไม่ตู้ไล่หว่าเราบ่นี่ไล่หว่าเราบ่เนี่ยเบ้กาลาอะกองซุงเนาะอ๋อนี่อินเสิร์ตปาแล้วส่วนเนาะอะกองปา เนี่ยป่ายกองตัวมาเนี่ยเนี่ยคาล่ะเนี่ยกองตัวเป็นเนี่ยแบมิวอ่ะแบอ่ะถั่วแล้วตะไนเอ่อฮู้กองไฉนวาญอมิงกองซีบิกองช้านตาออมมอมอะกองตัวมาอ๋อดีซีไว้อะคู่เหรอกองล่ะจองแน่หลูอันนี้แหละส่วนเออะคู่ซีกั่วกันเนี่ยจะนี่บาดเลยอ๋อบาลุแหละบาลุจะเลยเสียเออะน่ะเนาะบาลุแหละสรุปอะคู
ปีซีกงเจนเนเน่ชาบ้าล่ะเนี่ยอ๋อเบจินงาอีซีกั่วกะอะกองซงผิดแค่แล้วบ่ตรงนี้เลนนี่เลนนี่งาติกะเซตาอะกองมาเลยอ๋อดีปัญญาเลยนะอะกะบะดุเสียเนมาติงแค่อ่ะเออจรเราคู่อ่ะกูไปเล่นละบ่เลยคู่อ่ะกูเล่นละคู่อ่ะกูเออปะยินเนมาเบอะหยองบ่อะหยองเนี่ยอะเมียวๆชื่อล่ะบ่เบลุหยองเนี่ยจัตเตอะนีชื่อมั้ยเล่มมอนีชื่อมั้ยเราอะวาจีชื่อหยองชื่อมั้ยเนาะครับเราเราละเพ็ดละเพ็ดซิงกาล่ะชื่อมั้ย
เราดีเซลใช่ไหมอันนี้เราใช่ไหมสีอย่างใช่ไหมสีอย่างใช่ไหมแต่ยังกองตรงนู้นเท่านั้นใช่ไหมกองตรงก็เราจะโน้ตดีเราช่วยยังกาละกองตรงบอกอ๋อช่วยยังกาละกองตรงมาเลยดีปีนี้เราบดุเสียติงแค่เลยใช่ไหมลุลากันอ๋อฮะแต่มีปีนี้ติดเชลล์เปล่าเลยอย่างนี้ใช่ไหมอินสปอร์ตเนี่ยปีนี้นี่บอกลูกกาละดีดามิวกาละได้มาปานนั้นดีจีจงโอเค
When they see me, they know that every day when I'm breathing,
Located in the extreme north of Myanmar, Myitkyina is the capital city of Kachin State, with about 300,000 people living within the city. While the settlement might be the largest urban center nearest to Myanmar's best amber, Myitkyina is hard to reach by land on account of the country's dated infrastructure. If you don't have the cash to fly by airplane, companies are happy to take your money to bring you to the north of Myanmar through pothole-laced dirt roads when roads are an option. Burmese bus drivers will get the job done, even if it means taking the bus on short detours through swamps. But buses aren't the only land route available for intrepid foreigners looking for a deal. Perhaps the most reliable mode of transport remains to be Myanmar's slow-moving railways. This journey from Yangon to Myitkyina covers more than 1,000 kilometers of railway and takes about 40 hours by train. Overnight sleeper train beds can be purchased in advance at train stations, but the commute isn't for the faint of heart. Days turn to nights, and nights turn to day aboard Burma's railroads. But for me, it was worth the wait to get close to the origin of Burma's best amber.
to go far, you know, every time I see them.
Aboard the train, vendors stroll up and down the aisles or outside, peddling food and water. Quality isn't always guaranteed.
How much? So here we've got some Niagara purified drinking water. That's cool and refreshing. It's the water from Niagara Falls, it claims. It's cold, but come on.
They know that every day when I'm breathing.
Finally, upon reaching Machina, most foreigners will be accosted by taxi drivers looking to score a chance to make some money off a foreigner. Because of this, it isn't hard to get a ride to the local gem market.
Hello, taxi.
Making sure I have my phone, hang on.
Opening in the early hours on most days, Machina's gem and jewelry trade center is full of surprises. Every day inside the market is different, and gem hunters can buy pounds of rough amber or bags of polished bracelets and bangles. The price for these 100 million year old fossilized specimens varies greatly upon whether they're polished and ready to be worn on the wrist, or if insects are embedded inside. Rough stones can sometimes command a cheaper price, but when a foreigner rolls into town, it usually means the price tag is automatically much higher, at least before haggling begins.
And rough stone, you have polished or you can only do 1,000, huh? Okay, okay. Too much for me, I think.
Yeah, I think that was, now I think that is crazy, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Some of these rough stones might contain a rare, possibly extinct or prehistoric organism, which drives up the price from either hundreds of thousands to tens of thousands to $100, depending on what's inside, is how to determine whether it's worth buying a bag of amber or not. Usually, it's easier to tell what's inside if the outer layer, known as the skin, has been removed from the rough amber. The business of hunting for amber through rough stones without the skin removed is a complete gamble. The only way you can win big is if you jump on board and take the risk. Men like Marmar and Wei Lin, who are going out of their way to talk about the secretive business, are among the frontline workers who buy and polish amber from miners and their wives. Often they are targeted by cartels of rich local gem dealers who attempt to restrict and control the price of amber in an effort to absorb the most profit before the product is sold to end users. In a country as rich in culture and spirituality as Myanmar, it isn't uncommon for a gem hunter to give up his search for the day on account of a religious holiday, in which there are many. Such an occurrence happened to me recently, when I stepped into a celebration marking the end of the rainy season. When the festivities are over and conventional marketplaces are shuttered for the day, there's still time to score a deal on a rare, flawless, 100-million-year-old specimen of Jurassic-era amber. In Mycina, dealers of many substances, some licit and others not, gather together at nighttime to sell their products at tea shops. Several amber dealers in town have seen the biggest transactions of their lifetimes taking place on the sidewalk, perched atop cheap plastic chairs under the glow of a bare fluorescent light bulb. It's simply the local culture. And sometimes, especially for a foreigner, it can be best to simply blend in. This was certainly the case for my first trip to Kachin State. As an amber virgin, I was offered my first piece for free before I bought a whole bag of insect inclusions. But that's not all this isolated, remote, and untouched part of the world provides for amber hunters. As recently as December, a gem hunter based in Bangkok claims to have found a dinosaur head embedded in amber, originally from Kachin State as well. And while he refuses to disclose how much he plans to sell his specimen for, it's clear the international gem industry is hungry for more information about the stone. During a private showing of this new discovery, a gemologist made a surprise visit to validate the authenticity of the stone, which is currently undergoing laboratory testing.
My name is Yedu. I work on gemstones and I am a gemologist. I've been in this field for 18 years. My qualifications are diploma in gemology from GemA UK, and then following with a fellowship. At my hand, I'm looking at a beautiful amber. I love amber because it is time encapsulated, time frozen in something, in a resin, naturally. This is Burmese amber, extremely hard, extremely old, extremely rare. And the inclusion inside this amber, I haven't seen it really well, is something that is of paleontological era of dinosaur time, and that makes this piece very, very unique. Value is in the eye of the beholder, but to me, this is very valuable.
And what do you think the origin of the species is, just by the time, the amount of inclusions you've seen in your career?
Burmese amber is rich in different natural inclusions, or what it covers, the gum covers millions of years before. This looks like a bird from a dinosaur era. I haven't scoped it, but with the lens I could see animal, I could see fat, I could see blood, I could see hair, so it's exciting. But Burmese amber with all these three is quite rare. And I just think, I assume that this is a dino bird. I assume, but I don't know, but fat, hair, and the shape, the head, everything goes on to state that it is a dinosaur bird. So that's about it. So I think it's extremely rare, probably the one piece that I've ever seen in my life. That's why I came rushing today after my work to see this beauty. That's it.
Despite a century of exploitation from the West and around the world, many years ago, Burma is a wide open country, still full of riches and not yet penetrable from foreign influence. Perhaps now, one full year after its champion of democracy rose to power a year ago, it's time for foreign gem businessmen from around the planet to rise to the occasion and take the chance on Burma.